Hello. Ribby here, and I'm gonna go over all the stuff they announced at BlizzCon with the Year of the Gryphon. So let's get started. Year of the Gryphon. And here's the next expansions. I don't know World of Warcraft too much, so I can't really make any guesses on the next two. So the roadmap. So it looks like pretty standard stuff. We're getting updates, mini sets, every phase, and for phase 1 and 3, there's these spell locks. Wonder what those are gonna be. So the core set and site rotation. So the core set, if you don't know what it is, it's basically gonna replace classic and basic with a bunch of cards, and you get it for free, and it rotates every year, all the cards. So some of the cards, Annoyatron, Tomb Pillager, Tyrion, and Fireball. So we've seen all those cards. They're all pretty good cards, and yeah, good that they're staying. So Menagerie Warden and Assassinate will be buffed. Menagerie Warden, I don't think we'll see too much play, even with the buff. It still, like, maybe Broom, but this just doesn't really want to be doing with Druid. And Assassinate still just feels too slow. Like, you have Coerce, like, I don't think it's gonna see too much play. And the dragons, three dragons will be, so Ysera, Malgus, and Deathwing, they'll be different from their previous forms, and the old ones will be rotating to wild, but these are staying in the core set. So Ysera, add one of each dream card to your hand, and the dream cards will not be the same. So dream will be one mana sap, basically, and it's a nature spell. Emerald Drake stays the same. Laughing Sister got buffed. Nightmare only gives a minion +4/+4 and is a shadow spell. And Ysera Awakens doesn't target face, and it's a nature spell and 3 mana. So yeah, I don't know. Nerfing it, like, they wanted to buff the dragons, but nerfing it, like, kind of just seems counterintuitive. Maybe they would have been too broken. They probably know something we'll have to see, but I don't know. Malgus, the Spell Weaver, draw spells until your hand is full. This just seems very slow. 9 mana for card draw. It's like 9 mana Myra's and Steel Element, basically. Just doesn't. I don't think it'll be that great. Maybe with, like, I don't even think it's. Yeah, it just doesn't seem good. The old Malgus just seemed way better. Deathwing the Destroyer. Destroy all minions. Discard a card for each one you destroyed. Yeah, it's definitely an upgrade, but sometimes it's just gonna be the same thing. Like, I feel like the downside is still just too high. Yeah, it just doesn't. I don't think it'll be that great. Definitely an upgrade, though. There will be 29 completely new cards, and so yeah, let's go over those. Novice Zapper, 1 mana, 3/2, spell damage 1, overload 1, card for Shaman. This card seems insane. 1 mana 3/2, that's like flame up stats, spell damage. Like, the only 1 mana spell damage in the game is the Og Merchant, right? And Shaman, this card's just gonna be insane, I think, with like Landslide and Tunnel Trog and Wild. It's just, I think it's gonna be really good. Very, synergizes really well with your deck. With Landslide, that's just 3 mana, 4 damage AoE. That's just, I think this card's gonna be busted. Felsoul Jailer, 5 mana 4/6 demon, battle cry, your opponent discards a random minion, death row, return it. This card's really cool. I don't think it's gonna be that good, but it's like, it kind of stops combos, but it doesn't. I don't think it's gonna be that great. Like, you can, like, silence it, and then it, like, makes them discarded, but it's like a random minion, so. And I think it's just too slow, but maybe it'll be good. I don't think so, though. Overlord Runthak, 5 mana 3/6 rush. Whenever this attacks, give +1/+1 to all minions in your hand. So it's a cool hand buff card. Don't think you'll see too much play because hand buff isn't really the best, and yeah, I don't think it's gonna be that great. So yeah, Vanessa Van Cleef. This is Edwin's daughter, I believe, and she'll replace him, so Edwin will rotate to wild and be unnerfed, but Vanessa will stay. 2 mana 2/3 combo, an accompany of the last card your opponent played to your hand. Scarlet's pretty cool. It's a little slow. It's not slow, but it's just like 2 mana, 2/3, get one card. You also have to combo it. It's not. I don't think it's that great. And your opponent can also play around it by making the last card they play weaker. So I don't know. It's a cool card, and I think it'll be okay, but I don't think it's necessarily what Rogue wants to be doing. Alright, Thrive in the Shadows. 2 mana, discover a spell from your deck. Shadow. So this is like Shadow Visions. Shadow Visions is a really good card. It also draws the spell from your deck, because Shadow Visions says discover a copy. Now that could be a good or a bad thing. I think this card will be really good in Priest. It's card draw, which Priest doesn't really have. Actually, is it draw? I don't know. But it seems pretty good. Shared Shaman. Shaman's getting some buffs. Feral Spirits now only has one overload. This seems pretty good. Like, 3 mana, 4/6, only one overload. Like, two overload is just brutal. Like, just stops your curve. But Feral Spirits might see some play. Lightning Storm, deal 3 damage to all enemy minions, overload 2. Nature, it's a nature spell as well, these spell tribes. It's better, for sure. It stops the randomness. But still overload 2, and you already have like landslide and stuff, which I don't know if Shaman needs this, but definitely a buff. Earth Elemental, 5 mana, 7/8 taunt, overload 2, so it now has one less overload. Still don't think this is gonna see play. Like, it's a Jandis card basically still. You don't really wanna overload 2, just still a lot, and this isn't really what Shaman's game plan is, playing big minions, so yeah, I don't think you'll see that much play. There's also gonna be a new totem. It's gonna replace the spell damage totem, Wrath of Air. Strength totem. At the end of your turn, give another friendly minion +1 attack. So it's basically like Micro Mummy, but without the reborn and one less attack. Yeah, the spell power totem was. All the totems are situational, kind of, but I think the spell power one overall was like the best, because Shaman, you're usually running like lightning bolts and stuff in your deck, unless you're playing a control deck. So, yeah, and even in control, you want the spell power one, so getting rid of one of the best totems. If you want to buff the hero power, it doesn't seem like the best way to do it, but this totem seems very powerful, I think. Just getting attack. It's better than the 1/1 and stuff, but they're all kind of situational. So yeah, this card's cool. The classic format as well, it's just 2014 Hearthstone. Just like 4 mana Leeroy, Old Warsong, just all those cards. And celebrating by getting a golden pack, that's cool. The new mode, the Mercenaries. It's like an RPG game, and like, you do all these missions. I don't know too much about it, but it seems cool. Yeah. So it won't come out, it'll come out in phase one, but it won't come out like right as the expansion launches. Book of Heroes, or is this Book of Merge? I don't know. New player, okay, so now let's go to the Forge in the Barrens, the new expansion that they released. The trailer, yeah, okay, so the new keyword is Frenzy. This is when a minion takes damage and survives, it triggers the effect. So, Razormorn Raider, Frenzy, attack random enemy. It's okay. I don't think it'll see too much point construction. Maybe if, like, Inner Rage sticks around, it could be, like, 5 mana deal 7 to the face, but it's also random. It doesn't guarantee to go face, so I don't think it'll see too much play. Maybe an arena card, but yeah, it's okay. Blade Master Smora. 4 mana, 1/6. Frenzy, deal damage equal to minion's attack to all enemies. Doesn't seem too great. I don't know what deck would run this. Maybe like you would have to have like a lot of buffs with like Librams, I guess. Like that could go into like deal 2 to all enemies. But Frenzy, that doesn't seem like the best keyword, at least power-wise. And then Druid of the Plains, 7 mana, 7/6 rush, Frenzy, transform into a 6/7 Coda with taunt. 7/6, okay. Yeah. Doesn't seem that amazing. It just, like, sometimes it's like 7 mana, 6-7 taunt, kill a minion? That's okay. I don't think it fits into Druid's game plan, though. Okay, rank spells. So, yeah, there's gonna be tribes on spells, like Fel. That's a tribe, so... 2-mana Imp Swarm, rank 1. So, there's 3 stages in them. And summon a 3-2 Imp. When you have 5 mana, you summon 2 Imps. And when you have 10 mana, you summon 3. Scourge just don't seem good. Probably the best one is the 5-mana one, because that seems the most appropriate for the mana. Because, like, at 10 mana, getting 3 imps is not that amazing. At 5 mana, even then, you still kind of, it just doesn't seem good. Yeah, rank spells don't seem that amazing. Spell schools. So, restore 5 health to each hero, 0 mana, holy. And it synergizes with this, but this card doesn't seem that great. Yeah, I don't think this card will be that amazing. It's good with Nazmani, but yeah, it's okay. It's like 0 mana radiance because you're usually not going faceless as much with priest. So yeah, it'll be okay, I think. But off random stuff, maybe it gets worse. So spirit healer. Yeah, there's the Lightsteed card from the mini set that doesn't see too much play, so I don't see a reason why this one would see play. And you'd have to cast a lot of holy spells just to make it be good, and yeah, I don't think it would be good. Chain Lightning, rank 1, deal 2 damage to a minion. Pretty sure at 5 mana does 3 damage and to adjacent, and 4 mana, or 10 mana does 4 damage and to an adjacent. It's just better removal, I think, in Shaman. Even Lightning Storm and stuff. Like, yeah. Doesn't seem that great. Like, there's Lightning Breath. That didn't see too much play. You had to hold a dragon, but still. It synergizes with Brucan. 4-5-4, nature, spell damage 3. This card seems pretty good. It depends on what spells are nature and how many of them could go face, but it's just a lot of spell damage for the mana. It only does nature spells, but still good, and you can get him off primordial studies and stuff. I think he'll be good. It's like mini Malgos. Yeah, so there's some more core cards that got leaked from the BlizzCon video, so Grommash will be staying. That's good. He's just good for warrior, but if they take out Innerage, which who knows if they are, it might be bad. Grommash probably wouldn't see too much play. And then looks like Direwolf Alpha, Raid Leader. It looks like his health got buffed, cause since it's not green. Murloc staying. Ooze staying. That's a pretty big one. With self-sharpening sword and standard. Fire Elemental. It's like whatever. Looks like Tidal Surge, Elfin Archer, and Wind Fury. Actually, wait. Yay. Those are all staying. 6-mana Sprint. Sinister Strike. Poison. Poison Sting is kind of big for the aggro rogues and standard right now, with like Cutting Class, Beefs of Surgeon, Dustingo, Lone Champion, Jungle Panther, couple Geomancer, Cursed Alchemist, and Storm Watcher will be returning. Doesn't look like he got changed. I think he'll just be a little bit too slow. So yeah, that's gonna be the end of the video. Thank you guys for watching, like and subscribe, and